Before we hop into the video, we are giving away $100 worth of Amazon gift cards. To enter, make sure you leave a like on this video, subscribe to this channel, and comment something interesting about the video.
And winners will be announced on my first page, Kino King YT, at a later time. Also subscribe there so you don't miss your name possible being picked. Thanks and enjoy the video. Allen Iverson, high school, 5-star recruit, Virginia State Championship, high school player of the year, but not just for basketball. Yeah, that's right. Allen Iverson accomplished all this also playing as a quarterback for his high school football team. Multi-athlete, one of the most talented young prospects in the history of sports, Iverson got himself into trouble as a 17-year-old and did 4 months in correctional facility after he was granted clemency by Virginia governor due to insufficient evidence. Scholarships were dropping and for a moment it seemed like nobody was going to pick up Iverson, but then the legendary John Thompson of Georgetown University happened and he offered Iverson a full scholarship. With his 2 seasons with Georgetown, he won 2 Big East DPOY awards and led his team to an Elite Eight before declaring for the NBA draft. He entered, arguably, the best draft in the history of the league, along with Steve Nash, Ray Allen, Kobe Bryant, Stephon Marbury, the list just keeps going on and on. He was selected first by the Philadelphia 76ers. He was the shortest first pick ever. In his rookie season, Allen Iverson averaged 23.5 points per game along with 7.5 assists but with a little over 2 steals per game. He also had 5 consecutive games with 40-plus points, which is the record for the rookie, previously held by Wilt Chamberlain, including his 50-piece against the Cleveland Cavaliers. Oh yeah, and he crossed Michael Jordan. That's right. The move we've always seen on repeat was in his rookie season. He won Rookie of the Year award and had established himself already as one of the most fearless competitors in the league. 76 years back in the day were not that great coming back from 18-win season. With the addition of Iverson, they've managed to win just 4 more games. They've missed the playoffs once again, but they've seen potential in young Iverson, so they decided to build around him. In his 3rd year, Iverson clinched his first of 4 scoring titles and Philadelphia finally made the playoffs. They were swept by the Indiana Pacers in the East semis. Coach Larry Brown knew something had to be done to help Iverson, so in midseason 2000-2001 Iverson got help in All-Star center Dikembe Mutombo, who would go on to win Defensive Player of the Year award. Iverson got a Kobe Bryant All-Star Game MVP and went on to lead Philly to a 56-win season. Iverson was playing the season of his career with averages of 31.1 points per game and 2.5 steals per game, league leader in those categories. Philly went on to advance to the finals, but it wasn't easy for them as they've lost their energy in East semifinals and East finals, that featured one of the best matchups in NBA playoffs history between Iverson and Vince Carter. They've played 7 games in each of those series and they came to the finals as the underdog. The opponents were the three-peat Los Angeles Lakers team, with Shaquille O'Neal and Kobe Bryant. In the first game of the finals, Iverson demolished Lakers in the first half, scoring 30 points and giving Philly 6-point lead. Phil Jackson put Tyronn Lue on Iverson and he held him to a 3-point fourth quarter. Lakers managed to come back and force overtime. They were hungry for a W, but Iverson had other plans. He scored 7 points in overtime, which included the famous step over Tyronn Lue basket which helped 76ers seal their victory. Iverson delivered one of the all-time best finals performance with 48 points, 5 rebounds, 6 assists and 5 steals. Sadly, they would go on to lose the next 4 games. Iverson averaged 35.6 points, 5.6 rebounds, 3.8 assists and 1.8 steals per game. But unfortunately, it wasn't enough. He won Most Valuable Player honors that year and that was the highlight of his career. Philly would go on to lose in the first round next year, despite Iverson's scoring ability. He won another scoring title that season with 31.4 points per game. In a 2003-2004 season, 76ers actually missed the playoffs and that was the downfall of Allen Iverson. He didn't have the answer. He came into the league with his signature crossover, baggy pants and hoodies. He enjoyed partying and he wasted his talent by missing practice. Everything he did on the court was crafty and creative. So unique. He was truly one of a kind. He was often criticized for not passing the ball much. Here's what Kyle Korver, a rookie for the 76ers at the time, said about Iverson. When you were playing with him and you wouldn't be able to make a shot, he was like, "Why would I pass it to you? I'll just shoot it myself." After much disagreements with the coaching staff, he was traded to the Denver Nuggets in 2006-2007 season. He spent three seasons with the Nuggets before being dealt to Detroit, where he played for one season. He became a free agent and signed with the Memphis Grizzlies in 2009-2010 season, where he played just three games. It was a debacle. Memphis had terminated his contract because he sat out due to personal reasons. He just wasn't interested in playing off the bench. Iverson's career came to an end when 76ers signed him one last time on a one-year contract. He played 25 games and started in 24 of those games. He left the team indefinitely midway through the season due to personal reasons. This time it was legit. He played his last game in the NBA against the Chicago Bulls. He played 10 more games in Turkey with Beşiktaş, but in 2013 he announced his retirement, saying that he lost the desire to play. The shortest MVP, against all odds, such a shame to throw such a talent away. Three-time NBA steals leader, seven All-NBA, 11-time All-Star. Iverson was inducted into the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame in 2016. He got into financial trouble after his retirement and many players have supported him verbally. He chose all that over practice. He deserved so much more. That's it for today. I hope you like my video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Till the next time.